The aim of 3D science is to change science teaching as we know it. To reflect how science is practiced in the real world by scientists and engineers. Making science lessons more approachable, more engaging, and more reflective of the world students see around them. Instead of focusing on rote memorization, 3D science develops important skills, such as research, communication, and analytical thinking. While content knowledge is still a big part of what students learn, 3D science is about teaching students how to engage with new knowledge, answer questions,
keep growing, is that like this, then up here, then up here,
solve problems, and make connections between the scientific disciplines.
I like this one because it saves 3,000 gallons, but it doesn't cost anything.
As well as relating science to the real world. At the heart of 3D science are three dimensions of science learning: science and engineering practices, cross-cutting concepts, and disciplinary core ideas. With students at the center of 3D learning, SEPs can be thought of as what students do, CCCs as how students think, and DCIs as what students know. Every standard, also called a performance expectation, is supported by three dimensions. Science and engineering practices highlight methods that scientists and engineers actually use as part of their work, such as modeling, developing explanations, and engaging in critique and evaluation. Cross-cutting concepts are ideas that appear across several areas of STEM. They include concepts such as cause and effect, energy and matter, and stability and change. Disciplinary core ideas cover what we might also call content knowledge. They include key concepts in life sciences, earth and space sciences, physical sciences, and engineering and technology. Together, the three dimensions create opportunities for learning how to think and act like scientists and engineers while covering necessary content knowledge. Three-dimensional learning helps maximize student engagement and improve learning outcomes, giving students the skills and conceptual frameworks they'll need for a lifetime of investigation.